We are absolutely thrilled to start off our evening with our school superintendent, Lori White. It is a pleasure to introduce her, and I think I don't need to waste anyone's time by giving you her credentials, and I'm simply going to say, Lori, many thanks for coming for the introduction.
My pleasure. Thank you. You know, we have so many things to be proud of in this school district and in this community, particularly in the area of STEM. You look at our facilities, we've had huge investments in the technology infrastructure, the science classrooms, all classrooms integrating technology so teachers have multiple resources. When you look at programs such as Suncoast Polytechnical, when you look at the new SCTI and all the potential that we have in that facility and in those programs, when you look at all the career technical education programs that we've implemented at the high school level, more industry certifications than we've ever seen before. We're looking at a communication articulation to the middle school. So students come prepared to go in those many different areas. We have tremendous pride in what we've accomplished. And largely it's because of a community who supports us also with putting on themselves an additional tax at a time when we know they're suffering with the economic situation that this county feels very much so. So much to be proud of, but I've been sitting much of this morning and many mornings this past couple weeks listening to committees talk at the legislature and looking at some of the bills and some of the concerns that was brought with the governor's budget, and I will tell you it's real easy to get depressed. So how do we keep the vision alive and well and moving forward? Because for the students that happen to be going to school today, it's not like they have an option that, well, these are bad times, so sorry, there's going to be some rough years. This is their chance, and we owe it to them to figure out how can we work together despite some of these obstacles and challenges that are presented by the budget situation for us and for many of your organizations, just the economy that you're dealing with within your own organizations. The only way I feel we can continue to move forward is to work together. Now, there have been partnerships forever. We understand that. I think we're looking at a new level of a partnership. And that's going to take learning from each other. We're in a new time in education. When you look at math, science standards, it's at a new level. Rigorous, for mastery. We're looking at a summer project this year that will actually take those benchmarks and try to identify day by day what are the goals and the language that students will have to achieve in order to accomplish that benchmark. It's never been more challenging for teachers. And you as outside community organizations have a wonderful resource that we can integrate with that classroom experience. Because we do a lot. We are very good in school districts and in education of segmenting and identifying and isolating things, but that's not the real world. The real world is the integration of all that, communication skills, math skills, technology applications, and that's what's out there in these community organizations. So how can we use those resources and find a way to enrich what's happening in our classroom and what happens when our students venture out? Together, I think we can find those ahas. I don't think any of us have the answers alone. And I will tell you, it's the only way that we're going to continue to move forward in this district so that we can all be proud of the graduates of the next century. Thanks.